Hello, this is FMAX Solutions. I welcome you to yet another interesting mathematical discussion as far as proof by mathematical induction is concerned. Alright, so in our previous lesson, we just talked about proof by mathematical induction. Here we want to take an example. So, proof by induction, and we are looking at an example. So example one. So we are proving that. One plus two plus three plus and so on. Plus n is actually equal to half of n, n plus 1. And this is for all n being natural numbers. So we are doing this for all n being what's natural numbers. So to actually conduct this proof, we need to follow some steps which we looked at in our previous lesson. The first thing to do as far as this is concerned is to prove directly that this particular statement is true for the first element of the set of natural numbers, which in this case is what 1. So for n equals 1, then we need to see whether the statement is true. And that can only be achieved if the right side of the statement, which is this side, is equal to the left side of what the statement. So for n equals 1, we want to look at the left hand side. And any place that I see n, I'm going to put 1, because we say for n equals 1. So the left hand side, so I see n here, so I put 1. So we are in what, 1 for the left hand side. So I go to the right hand side and see if I can get n. So right hand side, so I see n here, so I have half of 1, then multiply by 1 plus 1. So this gives us 2 multiplied by half, and the result is 1. So in this stage, we say that the proof has been anchored. Well, the first thing that we have been able to prove directly that the statement is true for the first element of the set of natural numbers. Having done this, then we need to move to the next step, which is that we have to assume that this particular statement is true for n equals k. So second point, we say that so we assume that this particular statement, so you look at it here, we are adding. So we can, instead of writing all this, we bring a summation symbol to simplify everything. So assume that for n equals k, we are having the summation I begins from 1 up to k. It means we are adding all these things, starting from 1 up to k. Okay. It's true. Equals half of k, k plus 1. It's true. So for n equals k, means any place you see n, we put k. So the sum of this is equal to what? That one. And the next point is to use this assumption and prove that the statement is true for n plus 1, where n plus 1 is the successor of, where k plus 1 is the successor of what? K. So say that 3, using the assumption in 2, we're proving that for n equals k plus 1, then the statement is not going to be a summation what I begins from 1 up to k plus 1 will be equal to, so in that place we see k plus n, in this we put k plus 1, be equal to half of k
plus 1, then multiply by k plus 1 plus 1.
So we are putting k plus 1 here, so plus 1. So in effect, realize that this place becomes k plus 2. So we write k plus 2 here. So we are proving that this is equal to this. Now, to do this proof, the only thing we need to do is to be able to show that this one is equal to this, and that ends it. So let's look at the main proof. So main proof.
What are we proving?
That the sum, so I, where I begins from 1 up to k plus 1, is actually equal to half of k plus 1 and k plus 2. This is what we are proving. So we want this side to be equal to this, so we start from here. And when we get something similar or equal to this, then we can prove that yes, the proof has been completed. So let's take this. We have the sum up to k plus 1. Now you realize that we are adding on. So we start from 1, 2, 3. So we are adding 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 and plus n, then plus k, then plus k plus 1. So it means that before we add up to k plus 1, we might have passed the sum up to k. So it means that this will be equal to the summation from I equals 1 up to k. So we've added up to k. Then to get k plus 1, then we add k plus 1 then to it. So this gives us the simplification of the addition from 1 up to k plus 1 term. Right. But already we have stated that in our assumption that the summation up to k was equal to half of k into brackets k plus 2, or k plus what, 1. So it is appropriate for us to use this in place of this. So we are going to pick all this and place it here. So it means that we now have half k, then k plus 1, then plus k plus 1. Right. So we have this. Good. So we can put this in a bracket. So that looking at this, you see that this side and that side, the two terms, they have something in common, which we can factor. So we have in k plus 1, which is common, so it is factored out. We are left with half of k and plus 1. Right, so we have that. Let's look at how we can still rewrite this. Because we want this, whatever is here, to look like what is here. So that we can conclude that the proof is actually null. Now we have k plus 1. And we realize that if we take the LCM for this term, you see that we have 2 as the LCM. This goes here 1. So we multiply by that to give us k, then divided by what? 2. So we have k plus 2 divided by 2. So this can be simplified in that form. Now, I will look at that. This 2 here, so you have 1 here multiplied divided by what, the 2, giving us a fraction. So you can rewrite everything as half of k plus 1 and multiply by k plus 2. This is actually equal to this side. Means that the proof has been done. So we can conclude that, so the fourth one, conclusion, that for all n being elements of the set of natural numbers, 1 plus 2 plus 3 and so on plus n is equal to half of n, n plus 1. Good. So the proof is actually done. And thank you very much for your attention. We shall meet again to look at other examples. Bye for now.